legacy, revenge, if I pride it more. My whole life been disrespected, so after this you won't forget him. Guess you never got the message. What's going on, everybody, my beautiful people? Wolf Empire back at it again, you know. Alright, we're gonna do this Q&A.
Since someone's so angsty to answer, how many of us are single? Mr. Angsty Person, go ahead and start.
Just raise your hand.
I guess I'll go first. There we go.
I'm not. Sorry.
Up in the air.
I'm not.
Next
question.
I'm single for you.
When is Skyrim coming back?
Listen, shit. Oh, y'all. Okay, so the thing with Skyrim is, the way I edit Skyrim, because I edit everything off this phone, the way I edit Skyrim, it's a lot of memes and all that, right? And the way I like Skyrim is I could put the most of me into it. But the thing with Skyrim, it never ends, if you catch my drift. So I don't know how long I'm going to be doing Skyrim. Of course, I love and playing the game. I love doing commentary. I love doing the jokes and all that. As long as y'all like it, right? But I do have videos. I did record some videos. I just got to get along around the time to edit, because all the videos that I'm putting out now of me gaming is already pre-recorded, like, months back. So I'm still trying to catch up with that. So be patient, please.
What anime do we suggest?
Shit, all of them. Me personally, not going off the mainstream, obviously. Afro Samurai Champloo, Kami Got Killed. There's like so many. I don't know. Why y'all ask this question? Just pick an anime and just watch it. Black Lagoon, I got back into that. There's so many. Someone else go.
What about you, Faye?
Right now I'm currently watching Fate Zero, which is pretty good.
Saucy.
But another one that came to mind was Vampire Knight. Zero, he's been pretty cool and stuff. Yet,
so I'm not calling myself an expert over here, but I watch too much anime. So I mean, if you want to break it down into like categories, of course I'm a big mecha fan, so I'm always gonna suggest mecha, of course. So, but if you wanted something like with jokes but with seriousness and good storytelling, Gurren Lagann, good mecha, suggested. If we're going fighting, oh, we're not gonna go. I'm gonna go out more. I'm actually rewatching. I'm starting a new shonen. That's an old shonen, Reborn. I suggest that, especially like. Kind of like a mafia type of feel, but with a bunch of jokes. I suggest that. There's just so many that I'm going to suggest, but I'm going to cut it short. I won't get to it because there's too much on my list.
Yeah. With me, I'm gonna take
after he says the main screen, I'm like, bro, Naruto, Seven Deadly, Dragon Ball Z.
I'm gonna take all their advice because I haven't watched any of those, so I need to catch up on my anime myself. But I don't see Seven Deadly's not that mainstream.
It's pretty mainstream though.
Well, fuck it, go watch Seven Deadly Sins. Give a fuck if it's mainstream or not. Y'all want an anime to watch? Go watch it. Like Seven Deadly Sins is OP, and the next season's coming out. August 6th, make sure you tune in. Netflix, go check it out.
Not sponsored.
Hey, but Netflix,
hey.
But you know, the best anime out right now is Boruto. Oh, man.
I'm gonna head out.
Alright, next question.
Alright, back now.
They want more, any more gaming vids with us?
Oh. Us as a whole? Yeah, we're gonna do more gaming vids. We just gotta find a game that we can all play at the same time.
And that works with all of our schedules.
Yeah. Yeah. Because, you know, obviously, videos has been kind of scarce on this channel because we've been doing other shit, which y'all gonna see in October. Don't worry. You're gonna see in October. But other than that, yeah, we're gonna play some games together. Maybe put in some For Honor, Fortnite.
So if he gives me the email kind of freaking channel, I will put in scary games for y'all.
Yeah, we're going to find a game.
Obviously, Apex. You can't leave Apex out of that.
There's only three.
Let me know. Let me get y'all PSN names and shits like that, and I'll add y'all. We'll 1v1. We'll 1v1.
Don't do that.
We'll see how that goes.
If my subscribers drop because of you, I'm beating your ass. Right. Next.
Right. When are we doing a tournament?
It depends on what game y'all want to be. What game y'all want to get y'all asses beat on. But on the real. I don't know. Y'all let me know. Like, I don't know if y'all want to be in the tournament or do we have random people in the tournament.
Or do you want us just in the tournament?
We could do Smash, we could do Apex, we could do Fortnite, we could do Tekken, we could do all of that. We're going to get the tournaments, you know? We could do tournaments. I don't know, like I said, if y'all want to participate, let us know. But if y'all just want to see us, like, turning it out, whatever the fuck you want to call it, just let me know, alright?
Next question.
How many of us are in the Wolf Empire?
Woo! Alright, so, see, there's the Wolf Pack and the Wolf Empire. Now, my Wolf Pack has a lot of members spread out throughout the world, alright? This Wolf Empire is basically the business fun side of it, alright? So, we're in the building stage of the Wolf Empire. Besides this YouTube stuff, we're also doing stuff outside that we don't post. Don't worry, we're gonna start posting some of that next year. Because fucking COVID. But, yeah. So, right now, it's us. And then my wife, and we have some few pending members, because I'm not letting anybody inside the Wolf Empire. I don't want lazy fucks or dumbass or whatever the fuck you want to call it. I don't want anybody to be in the Wolf Empire. You feel me?
Next.
This could be a while. New Broly versus Old Broly in debt.
Oh, okay.
And what?
In debt. Because I think we touched this on another video. Okay, yeah, so.
Yeah, it was just the three of us at the time.
All right. So, I like all the both Brolys. I say all Brolys because the third time he came back, what the fuck was that? But we don't talk about that. I like both Brolys. New Broly has a lot more character development. The old Broly, he just came to fuck shit up and they did him so dirty that they defeated him so fucking dirty. So fucking dirty. That in old Broly storyline, like I said, if you watch the bridge version, they clown him several times. But he didn't have no purpose. Like, I get it, he wanted to be revengeful and shit. Alright, cool. You know? But they made him to just, like, hate Goku. And I was just like, what the fuck? Like, every time, Kakarot. Like, come, bro. Like, what the fuck? Like, the main reason of his rage was because Goku was crying beside his bed while he was trying to sleep. Come on now.
Yeah.
Come on now. Like, no. But if you want to take power into effect, because we all have those fucking bitch-ass niggas on there. But if you want to take power into effect, obviously, New Broly fought Super Saiyan Blue, Goku, and Vegeta at the same time. The last person we saw that did that was Jiren. So, you know, I'm just putting that out there. I mean, I'm just putting that out there. But I just like it because the more that he fights, the stronger he gets. And Gogeta knew that, and he did not waste no time with that motherfucker. He got him the fuck about. So I had to give it to New Broly. Your turn.
Touched everything.
I agree with everything that Crusader said, but I do like to add one thing though. Especially, granted, I am in favor of New Broly because I like his more of the more savageness side, of course. Persistence. Yeah, persistence. But at the same time, I also do like old Broly's intelligence.
Yeah,
because I mean he actually came up with a plan. And like
an airplane.
But no, like a plan, like in a way.
I mean that was mostly like his father though.
Oh yeah, at the same time though.
That nigga killed his own father though.
I mean both of them.
No, Frieza killed New Broly's father.
Yeah.
Fucking bitches. Anyways.
But, you know, it's, you know, I'm definitely a favorite New Broly. I do like, I just like his character design more, personally, too.
Old Broly was just fucking them up, though. Like, he had Vegeta shook. I've never seen Vegeta be more of a bitch than right then and there when Broly showed up. That, oh my god, he was scared to fight Broly. Come on, bro.
Yeah.
They played the fuck out of Broly and Vegeta.
Hell yeah. I'm just gonna go along with what they said, only because I haven't dove that deep into Dragon Ball at all to freaking, I don't know old Broly that good. I only know new Broly, so I can't really compare them. I don't like to compare things I don't know about.
Mm-hmm. Next question. One mistake we ever made.
Oh shit!
All right, let me get my notebook out.
I'm gonna just say the biggest mistake. The biggest mistake
that we ever made
for me personally is caring what people thought about me. Well, that's one.
That's one.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna break the rules. All right. Caring what people thought about me and fucking looking back in the past.
We do not have any of the rights of the music. You hear any music in the background.
Yeah, we
have. Just like you know.
We have a part. But yeah, I would say those are my two biggest mistakes, and I guess y'all obviously want me to explain it. The things I do for y'all. Okay, so
the things I do for love.
So,
I love y'all.
For the first one, caring what people thought about me. In general, this goes for anybody out there. You ever notice what stupid shit that you do when you care what people think about you?
Oh,
like, let's think about this, right? The stupid shit that you do to impress that girl. Yo, I'm not talking about any girl. I'm talking about that first one. That first one?
The first love.
The first one. You know how J. Cole said it? Wet dreams, you feel me? The first one. The stupid shit that we do. That men do. I know that. Just stupid. Stupid shit. Like, me personally, the stupid shit that I did. Oh, my God. Let's just say, if I didn't care what people thought about me, then I wouldn't have went to jail the first time. Let's just say that. We're just gonna put that out there. Let's just say that. All right. So, let's just say that was the first time, and then like I would say after that, and some other shit happened. I'm not gonna go into depth. Just watch your back. The people that are around you in your circle may not always be with you. They might be actually plotting against you. I had to find out the hard way, clearly. But just stupid shit. So if I could take that back, I'll be good. Because I stopped giving a fuck after that, and my life became way more happier. I got stayed out of trouble, just having fun, loving life, everything. Everything, because I didn't care what people thought.
Yeah.
At all. And what was the other one that I said? I can't remember. Looking back from the past. So, obviously, if you had a bad past, why the fuck would you look back from it? You're supposed to grow from it. Like my favorite character, Sonic, says, keep moving forward. You feel me? So, I'm going to leave it at that. Your turn.
Making everyone happy, you can't do. Like, no one's going to, everyone's not going to love me. Harsh, but true. And another thing is, listening to what your haters say. Don't ever listen to them. They're there to like block with your goals and what you want to do. So you keep at it. Keep your head up. Stay strong.
Pause real quick. So with the haters, y'all remember how many haters that we had on this channel on Wolf Empire at first? I appreciate y'all. I didn't even have to say anything. Because I was just asking them questions. Like, they'd be like, oh, you're so lame. Oh, this shit is whack. You curse so much. Then why the fuck are you watching me? Like,
you're giving us abuse.
I know, right? Like, get the fuck on.
Write in the comments.
Get the fuck on with your life, bro. Like, why the fuck are you watching us? There's millions of channels to watch. But you decide to come back to this channel to post that comment that no one gives a fuck about.
Not just once, but twice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where are you now?
Exactly.
Out the window.
I mean, let's be honest. They wouldn't say that shit to our face because they get their ass beat real quick.
Yeah.
Real fucking quick. It's some internet gangsters. But it's alright, though. Pussy's gonna be pussies.
You know what? You go ahead and take it first.
I'm still thinking. I have a lot of things on my mind.
All right. So I'm gonna break the rules a little bit more.
That's five. John looks like a face head.
Honestly, my first one, of course, is actually ironically a book of what they both said of people like getting your way for your success. Because honestly, like especially like with my business alone, a lot of my family didn't believe in me, what I can do. And now, ironically, I'm making more money than a lot of my family members today. But it drove me nuts for the longest time because I had to get one certification to do this. One. And it took me about 3 years, about roughly, to even think about even going for it because I was too scared because people judged all the way how I talk, the way I look, and everything else. And I was scared because I work with very well off people 95% of the time. And it's pretty scary to see that, you know, take over some like your own personal life and to actually not be able to do what you love. And that hurts more than anything else. And I said, fine, fuck it and just go for it. And I'm so happy with that now. But second mistake. And this is kind of bringing up a little bit more of a personal thing. And it's more of I used to self-harm a lot. And I'm not very proud of that. That fact, because it's not the right mindset for a lot of things. But at the same time, you just got to bounce back even harder and ignore the physical signs. Exactly. Make sure you knock off that like one. But just that build up to get out of that hole is what is the best thing. So bounce back with mistakes. So.
I just want to touch on that a little bit. But also asking for help if you need help. Asking.
Preach.
Just ask anyone. Ask anyone who you trust to help, to confide in. There's numbers to call. there's freaking numbers to text, because some people don't like talking.
That's true.
You can text them. It's just, don't ever let it get to that point, and don't let yourself feel like there's no one there for you, that there's no one listening, that there's no one seeing what's going on, because trust me, everyone sees it. I used to think no one saw it. Everyone saw it. Just ask for help. We all go through shit. No one's perfect. I know me personally, I've gone through the same shit. There's always going to be help. Me personally, I have a lot of regrets. I have a lot of them. I don't want to name their names because I don't want to call them out, but it's a lot of female. I'm just kidding.
It's going viral.
My ex-wife?
Bruh.
Just kidding.
Not touching that shit.
He just went there.
No, oh, but my two beautiful kids came out of it, so it's awesome. But no, I was just joking about that. I do have two beautiful kids, though. They're fucking awesome. But no, I would say my one biggest regret is putting limitations on what I can do. Limiting myself and making myself think that I could only go so high, I can only achieve so much, and stopping there. Like, people always say the sky's the limit. Fuck that bullshit. You got niggas going to Mars, going out the fucking universe. Like, the sky's not the limit. Go follow your dreams. Do what the fuck you want to do. It doesn't matter what people say. A lot of parents, oh, don't do that. It's dangerous. Don't do that because you don't know what's going to happen. Exactly, you don't know what's going to happen. You could find the love of your life across the fucking world. But if you never take that step to go across the world, you're never going to find the love of your life.
True story.
Like, just take that leap of faith. Just go for it. Just do it.
Next question.
Router or refrigerator? PS5 or Xbox Series?
Wait. Preach.
Oh, I know this comment. It said no PC.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe because of me.
It's probably because of him, right? But PC is the way to go. I don't have one yet. I'm going to get one. But
it's beautiful.
But I think we all know the answer. Y'all all know the answer that we're going to say. Xbox. No. PlayStation 5 all the way. I speak for all of us. Because I know them. PS5 all the way. Like, bro, no. All y'all got is Halo right now. But I know Xbox got some motherfucking, maybe some bangers, but you know.
But no exclusive though.
But I'm still waiting for that Dragon game that Xbox One was supposed to drop.
Oh, Scalebound.
Oh yeah, what happened to that?
Microsoft? I think they lost it in Nintendo's
supposed to. Yeah, I wonder what happened on there. That's crazy. But anyways, no.
We're gonna get sued.
But it's funny because, like, when PlayStation 4 dropped and Xbox One dropped, everybody was dogging on PlayStation 4 so hard because they didn't have any exclusives at first. They had PS3 games remastered on the PlayStation 4. The only exclusive that came out was Knack. Because I remember this because I bought a PS4 and I was like, did I make a mistake at first? And then he had Xbox One and we played the Halo game. Trash.
It was.
Gears of War. And then PlayStation came back and was dropping exclusive bangers, 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 bangers. And I was just like, damn, those Xbox people, are quiet right
until
now.
Until Dawn.
I'm about to Google this shit.
Until Dawn, Spider-Man, God of War.
God of War.
Last of Us. Come on. Stop.
And for the people who are complaining about Last of Us 2,
shut
grow
the
up.
Fuck up. That is a beautiful game.
Have an open mind when you play new games. Don't expect things to go your way.
Oh, I forgot. Resident Evil. Remastered.
Mm-hmm.
Crash and Spyro, even though they got it on Xbox, which I don't know why. I don't know why y'all got Crash, Spyro, and Kingdom Hearts. The fuck? Y'all got smoke? Get the fuck out of here. Anyways, but y'all
don't
know.
So I'm not even gonna lie, I'm looking this up right now. I saw it saying that Xbox only has like 10 exclusives.
Hmm. But they're like names I've never heard of before. Listen, that no one's ever gonna play.
I forgot. Y'all got Halo and Gears.
Forza. The fuck is Forza?
It's a racing game.
Yeah. I used to be a big racer person. That's back when I had an Xbox. Yeah.
360.
Oh, you mean Red Rings of Death?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Two of them.
That's crazy.
Two of them.
That's crazy. What's Xbox. All the way.
What made us want to do YouTube?
So, me personally, I don't know if I did this on my other channel or not.
What about the people?
The people. You stupid. So, back in the day, I'm going to go old school. Half of y'all ain't even going to know what the fuck I'm talking about. All right? So, we had these things called VCRs. Right? So,
what is that?
Yeah, VCR. And you used to go to the store and you buy blank tapes.
Yeah. Really?
So, it had a special option. It was rewind, play, and fast forward. They also had a special option on VCR. That's press record. Now,
that's how you got everything.
Mm-hmm. I used to get everything. But, so, I used to have, like, an N64. I remember this. My first video. The N64, I was playing Mario 64.
Oh, man.
And I was like, yo. And I recorded it on the tape.
Nintendo has better exclusives than Xbox.
True. We're off the subject. Off the subject. Damn. But anyways, so I used to play Mario 64, and I used to hit record on it. And then, like, I would record my gameplay, and I would show my friends, and I had my own commentary. And I thought it was so cool. They thought it was so cool.
It was lit.
It was lit, you know? Mario 64, you're fucking 8, 9, 10, you know?
Yeah. I think we're younger than that. I was
gonna
say six.
No, I was recording for years though. I was recording Jack and Dexter. PlayStation 2 dropped in 1999 to 2000, so around there.
So yeah, we were about six. Well, I was even six.
I was around seven or eight. But yeah, so I started.
I'm oldest though.
I started around there.
Sorry.
Isn't that funny? And then I didn't revisit that until, funny story, I actually have another YouTube channel way back when I first joined the Army, but it got shut down. Why? Because I made a few jokes on there that people didn't like. Yeah, so that got taken off. Then I just stopped that. Man, people are sensitive nowadays, but... Mm-hmm.
Babies
having
babies.
Man. And then it was back, I think I got out of the Army and I was playing Skyrim. And my wife was like, why don't you record this? This is funny. Like, she would laugh at my commentary because I talk to myself. Everyone does. Shut the hell up. Don't judge me. But anyways, so I would talk to myself. She was like, this is funny. You should put this out there. And I, you know, she said that I'm a young person, but I have a soul of a, like, a 6-year-old person, because I'm very wise, that's what she says, and I'm just like, okay, I guess, you know.
Is that 6 or 60?
60.
Oh, okay. It came out like 6.
But, yeah, so that's why I started YouTube. I got two channels. They all have channels except for KOK.
I'm working on it.
He's probably just gonna post on here. But anyways.
After, like, high school, I kind of really did nothing but work. I went to work, home, watched Dashy, Corey, PewDiePie. It was like, they seem like they're having fun. I wanna have fun. I'ma do that. Started, by the way, Silver Fang, X Silver Fang.
Wow.
Plug.
So yeah, have fun. That's I did it as a hobby. I'm still doing it as a hobby.
We all do it as a hobby.
Mm-hmm. I don't have a channel. Oh. For me, I think it all just started with just me just hitting that save video on the system. Just save your video, save your clip, whatever it was. And then I started going through and editing those clips, and I was just like, you know what? Like, I started watching a whole bunch of gaming channels and a whole bunch of different, just different types of channels, whether it was gaming, whether it was freaking animations, whether it was, just commentary, and I was just like, this is awesome. Like, this stuff makes me laugh. This stuff entertains me. Like, the longest time I was on YouTube rather than Netflix or Hulu, because a lot of YouTubers are more entertaining, which is sad, because Netflix and Hulu is an entertainment app.
Rick and Morty season 4, please, at Hulu.
Yeah. And Morty. It's entertainment. And I told myself, if I could provide that entertainment for other people and they can enjoy it, I'm going to try my best to do it. Like, and I'm still doing what I love to do. I'm just gaming like normal. I'm just doing it like I do every day. And, hey, I'll post it. If you like it. If not, that's cool. Because I'm still enjoying what I do. It is what it is. It is what it is.
But honestly, since I've actually kind of like joined you guys with just doing this, I just enjoy it. Just having fun. And two, I mean, all of us work.
We all don't have jobs.
Yeah.
Just putting that out there.
Well, like, we do a lot of work. I mean, and this is like the only time that we really do get to hang out. Like, all four of us all at the same time. Sometimes it's harder for us to do that all the time, and it's honestly a blessing in disguise, because it's like, one, we get to hang out with the boys, and two, we get to actually have fun and just make fun comments and just be ourselves the whole time and make you guys happy and bring up your day while bringing up our day at the same time. Yeah. I mean, I think that's awesome.
Look at my description on my channel. It's just to make you guys happy.
We get it. Next question.
This is for you guys. You guys. How long were you guys in the army?
6 long years.
I'm sorry. I was only in for about 2.5 years.
2.5? I thought it was like 2. Or 1.5.
It was a little bit over 2.
Because I remember you got out of basic. You went to Stewart, right?
Went to Stewart for a little bit.
And then you went to
Germany for a while.
Then you got in trouble.
Yeah, and then I came back to Stewart. So it was over 2. It was maybe a little bit before the half. So 2 and 3. 2 years, 3 months. Something about that.
Sure. Does West Coast count?
But let's not talk about
it. Yeah. Next question.
Luffy or Naruto?
What sense, though?
This, yeah, exactly. When I heard this question, like, what sense are we talking
about? Are y'all talking about, like, who would win in a fight? Or who's the better character? Or whatever. So, I'm gonna touch whatever, right? So, no, I'm off. So... So
no, don't touch me. Yes, my no square.
All right, so I'm gonna have to go.
Right, Sasuke,
what? That's not funny. You have 2 kids.
Man, that trail's so looking good right
hashtag
now.
Hashtag deadbeat. Anyways,
wow. No, I'm not.
So, anyways. I'm going to have to go with Luffy, only because I'm not saying Naruto is trash. I'm not saying Naruto is trash at all. People complain about One Piece being so long all the fucking time. I see that all the fucking time. But how many of y'all have actually sat down and watched it? That's 1. 2. He has to sail across the fucking world. What makes you think that's going to be a quick-ass journey? And he's trying to be King of the Pirates, okay? Do y'all know what it takes to be King of the Pirates? You know how many motherfuckers you have to deal with to fight? All that shit? And on top of that, they keep getting lost? Hurricanes? bro, come on now. Like, stop it. So I'm going to have to go with Luffy because I like his character development. Obviously, it's more to work with than Naruto. Naruto fucking fillers. Who would win in a fight? I would have to say Luffy. Only because he's the rubber man. Like, if Naruto throws anything at him, he'll probably just bounce that shit back. He's shown that in several times, even in the beginning. And Luffy just keeps on getting stronger. Naruto kind of stopped training because he's Hokage. Like, let's put that in effect. And I know he got Kurama and all that. Yeah, that's cool. But Luffy got a new form, too. I'm not going to spoil anything, but Luffy got a new form, too. So, I'm going to have to say Luffy on stronger and who's the better character as well. That's just me.
You.
Oh, me? Okay. For personality aspect, it's a different answer for me. I'm going to have to go with Naruto because Naruto made me feel his pain. Naruto, I felt his pain when he was alone because that's how I felt in high school.
Okay, I'll give you that.
And to the fact that he just thrives just for people to like him makes me like Naruto more.
Do you even watch One Piece?
Do you even watch One Piece? Yeah. Y'all watch at least a couple of first couple seasons.
It goes by fast.
Yeah. It fucking does. See, I'm kind of like in between, especially for this one, because of course. Sorry, bud. One Piece came out before.
Don't feed the video, man. Stop killing books.
Sorry. Peter, don't come after me.
Wow.
Like, One Piece came out before Naruto, for us, at least stateside. And then Naruto came out our 7th and 8th grade year, something like that. So I liked Naruto's, like, because I actually watched the full thing of Naruto, but I also have to give it to Luffy because if he can make me laugh, I'm having a good old time. That's why I like his goofiness, especially him being as a leader. A lot of people are like, he's not a leader, but he is.
He is.
He's one of the biggest leaders out there.
He got his own fleet right now, too.
Yeah. So, I mean, it kind of shows. Like, Naruto has a nation. If not almost, like a continent worth. Mm-hmm. But, fighting wise, I might have to give it to Naruto, man. Because, I mean, granted, like, Luffy, because I see all the fighting scenes with Luffy, because YouTube, but granted, I just feel like, even like with his rubberness, he still gets cut.
True.
So like, even like with, like, personally, like a wind shuriken might just fuck up his day.
Or he might just eat that shit.
Or he might eat that. That is true.
He done that before, attacks.
He's done that. But, you know, it's kind of like a stalemate for me personally with a lot of it, but I don't know. Stalemate.
It's hard to say. Once again, like, I haven't fully gone through One Piece. I've probably watched like the first 10 episodes, but I will give it this. One Piece from the beginning wanted the smoke. Like the first episode, if not the second episode, there was already fighting.
The first episode was fighting.
Yeah. I mean Naruto,
all 10 episodes.
Naruto, the first episode, all it was Sasuke and Naruto kissing. Like,
hey, if you guys watch it, Shikamaru's in the background.
So, but I have always been a big Naruto fan because I did watch it all the way through from Naruto to Shippuden to even partially Boruto. Partially. And when I mean partially, I mean like 500 episodes. But, it wasn't...
There's not even that many. Ow!
No, there's a lot. There's a lot.
That's fucking sad.
Are you counting Chipotin and
Boruto together?
Are you counting that together?
No. Boruto has about... Well, maybe I didn't probably watch 500. I probably watched about 300 episodes. And, and most of the time, granted, most of the time.
Not even that far?
Most of the time, I was on my phone doing shit and just listening for fight scenes. And then I would look up and pay attention and then go back on my phone. There was a lot of fillers. That's one thing. I haven't seen One Piece to know if there's a lot of fillers or not. But fucking Naruto.
I mean, almost every anime has a filler.
Yeah.
So that's hard. Especially with One Piece having 900 episodes. I mean, it's going to have some filler arcs.
I mean, it's finally coming to an end.
So, I don't know. I don't know. I can't compare them. Because I know more Naruto than I do One Piece. So.
All right, we're going to have to get back to that. Next question.
Thoughts on Kingdom Hearts 3.
I'm going to let you all handle that.
Because you haven't played it, right?
Nope.
There's 156.
Oh, but I've only watched...
Well, there's your answer, 156 episodes.
I've only watched like 56 of them.
I think 57 just dropped this week. Oh, okay. No, it doesn't matter.
Thrown out a random number. It felt like a lot.
Because it was bullshit. That's probably why. So boring. Yeah.
Kingdom Hearts 3.
Yes.
Okay, so...
I haven't played it.
It's an amazing game.
Amazing. Spoil it for me.
Hey, shut the fuck up. Anyways, it was an amazing game. When I first played it, I didn't cry, but, you know, I got hyped.
You cried.
No.
Single tear, man.
I got hyped. I'm not going to spoil it for y'all, for those who haven't played it yet. Go play it. If you play the other ones, please.
Because you'll spoil it for me.
Shut the fuck up. So, if you haven't played at least...
I mean, you gotta at least play 1-2.
You gotta at least play 1-2.
And then you have to
Chain of Memories. You gotta play the one with...
Roxas and all of them.
Roxas, whatever. And then you gotta play that one, too.
Yeah.
With Terra and Aqua and Ventus to get the story. Now, for the fighting, fucking phenomenal. I mean, the second one, they had the little gauge form and stuff, and, you know, it was cool, but it cost, like, one of your buddies, right? And then, also, it took a long time to charge up and shit. You can only have 3 members to a party, you know? This one, you can have as many members to the party as you want, which I fucking love. Graphics, amazing. Storytelling-wise, it felt short to me. They only had, like, what? Not a lot of Disney worlds in this one. It was not a lot of worlds at all. I felt like this one was shorter than the other two. That's just my opinion.
So waiting for a Kingdom Hearts park in Disney World.
That's coming too. But
really?
I think so, yeah.
Kingdom Hearts what?
Kingdom Hearts Park.
Oh, probably.
But
that right to be dope.
It's amazing. I like it.
All I gotta add in that. Since we're talking about what you gotta do, is have at least more than a 500 gigabyte PlayStation. What you gotta do is either go buy an external hard drive or go buy like the 2 terabyte one. That's what you gotta do. Because these 500 gigabyte fucking PlayStations, you're not going to be able to get through half the download of the first
salty
one.
Salty as fuck.
Like, I got one of them because I haven't upgraded yet because, I mean, the new PlayStation 5 is going to come out. What's the point? hopefully that one comes out with like 1 terabyte starting off.
You know they won't.
They probably won't. But it's just like there's not enough space. There's not enough.
Well, yet Xbox is doing it, but with no exclusives.
Got all that space.
They better have all that space. How big it is? Like what the fuck?
Oh my god. I think Kingdom Hearts 3 was pretty lit, but. At the same time, I do like that, but I do miss the other forms at the same time. Because I enjoyed 2 a lot. That's just me personally.
Because I like the forms, I like the Shadow form, I like the Valor, etc., etc.
I mean, they have the Shadow form, but they don't have the Valor where you get two Keyblades and shit like that.
See, I like that. I like the dual wielding aspect of everything.
That shit was dope.
I forgot what I was going to add, because...
I love the Yo-Yo form. You already know. That Yo-Yo shit went
hard.
Yo-Yo.
I'm blanking on all I wanted to say. Alright, next question.
Top tier anime.
Boys! Gundam. I don't care if anyone says Gundam. I can understand if you're not an OG fan, and that's okay.
Yeah, crawling across the
whole thing. I don't know, right?
Well, if you see
like his arm length reaches. Oh.
But honestly, I mean, it did. Anime. Wait, what was the question?
Our top tier anime.
Oh, top tier is for me, it's Gundam. That's easy. Gundam or anything like mecha related. Gundam.
The SpongeBob anime did the drop.
That was pretty good, though. That was pretty good.
Stop playing, bruh. shit, I don't have one. Like, I need
a
good
favorite. It's hard.
My top tier anime, lit story, right? It has to be lit story, character development, fighting, and just a little bit of romance in it, just a little bit, you know.
SAO.
Get the fuck out.
I can't name any top tier. I name a lot of animes that I like, but top tier. We're gonna have to come back to that question for our next Q&A.
Full Metal Alchemist.
Which one, though?
The original.
Original, okay.
For me...
Brotherhood's opening one, though. That's a good song.
Everything is lit.
Freezing. I'm just playing. That's not my top tier, but it's a good one.
I was like, he just likes it because of the titties, y'all. Don't let him pull you.
All that
titties,
bro.
The titties be out there. But that's not my top tier. I haven't watched a lot of animes, but the one I have watched is Seven Deadly Sins. So I'm gonna have to go with Seven Deadly Sins. Like,
I mean, how many animes have you watched total?
Naruto, Seven Deadly Sins.
Naruto, only through Naruto, okay. Seven Deadly, not even Freezing, because I've only seen like the first two seasons.
There's only two seasons.
Oh, first season. I've only seen the first season. So Naruto and Seven Deadly are the only ones I've watched.
Have you watched One Punch yet?
Oh yeah, I watched that too. Oh, One Punch is really fucking good.
Yeah.
Damn, forgot about that. Then One Punch. Yeah, One Punch is pretty lit. Thank you for telling me about that.
You're welcome.
Yeah, that's Saitama. Saitama's something else. Like, how the fuck you go train so hard that you lose your hair?
That's called steroids.
When is your most anticipated anime coming?
Demon Slayer Season 2.
Yes, Demon Slayer.
High School of the Dead Season 2. What was the other one? Dead Man Wonderland. Attack on Titan Season 4.
Find me.
I mean, Dragon Ball Z Super. I just want to see what they do. Of course, it's not better than Z, obviously. Fuck.
Come on, story.
You don't get that gay shit.
It's an anime.
I would say... I consider Boondocks an anime. I'm sorry.
I mean, it's a comic thing. It's
a fucking anime, y'all. Okay? Like, I'm sorry. If you kick a fucking fireball out of the air to a person, I don't care if y'all playing kickball. It's a fucking anime. They did a scream and everything. But anyways.
I mean, if they count Avatar as an anime, I mean, I feel like Boondocks would be an anime.
I would say Boondocks, but I'm scared to see what season, because season 4 was trash, and that hurts me to say that. Season 4 was trash. They're rebooting it, but Granddad, rest in peace, John Witherspoon, he passed away, and I don't know what they're gonna do with that. Of course, obviously, the actor is more important than the fucking
character.
Like, you can't replace him. But shit, I almost got.
You almost got the scene with
Tiago. Boy. But yeah, so I don't know, but those are my enemies. I don't know if they're gonna do another what's it called? Chrome Shelling?
Chrome Shelling.
Yeah. No, they're gonna do a season on that? I don't know, but
the next volume of Ruby.
What do you mean, bootleg Soul Eater?
No, I'll play it. No one turns into weapons in Ruby.
I mean, Penny is a weapon, though.
She's a robot.
She's a weapon, though.
Shut.
I mean, she's used for the military, so I mean, granted, she's a weapon.
She's a robot, she doesn't count.
We're only picking on him because we know that's his favorite anime, all right? We joking, y'all.
What's yours besides Ruby?
I haven't seen Demon Slayer yet, but they've been wanting me
to
watch it.
It is.
And they're making it sound really good, so I might have to check it out. So if that's the case, then Demon Slayer. Yeah.
Demon Slayer.
Yeah.
And don't follow the trend, please. Don't fucking follow the trend. Don't be one of those trendy anime watchers, please. I mean, it's already too late because anime is mainstream now and it's popular and everybody wants to ride the fucking wave. But they was the same motherfuckers that were saying that shit was lame back in the day. Yep. But y'all watching anime now. Not a bunch of dick riding. Alright, anyways.
See, my list is too long. Because anime, yeah. It's cool. But honestly, Demon Slayer Season 2, personal pick. An anime that I think none of you guys actually watch. Log Horizon Season 3. That shit's gonna be lit. I love it. It's not the SAO. It's not like that. It actually has good character development, good story.
Okay.
Honestly, no suggestion, Log Horizon. But other than that, there is one trendy anime that I'm actually excited for. I forgot how to pronounce it, but it's a Shield Maiden anime. It's a gaming one, but it's the character development and how I'm not calling her stupid, because she's just a young girl that doesn't know how to play a game. It's her first ever game being played. She becomes OP because she puts all her points into defense. She doesn't know how. She doesn't take damage. It's hilarious. And all the skills that she gets. But yeah.
You already know.
The Barbie Girl series.
My little pony.
Seven Deadly Sins.
We're just going to start off with Seven Deadly Sins. Obviously, Demon Slayer. I don't know if they're going to make another One Punch.
They are.
But I'm hoping they do. Definitely that. What else?
This is crazy.
That's really it I could think about right now.
Oh shit, last question? Alright, what is
last
it?
Last question.
Apex or Overwatch / Apex or Fortnite?
Overwatch. Like, let's be honest now.
No thanks.
We all know Apex is just a bootleg version of Overwatch.
And Fortnite.
Just see him just like, grrr.
He is a big Apex fan. I don't know if he just likes to play Apex because, you know, he's good at it or he doesn't have PlayStation Plus. But! But he is good at Apex. He is OP.
So don't 1v1 him.
So that's why I said don't 1v1 him. Because he would... I don't have any
there
words.
Was a time
what
where I played Apex with him, and I got 3 kills. He got 0 damage and 0 kills. The next game we played, he pushed 5.
Within the first minute. So it is what it is.
And he was upset. He was like, "Man, I didn't do no kills. Got no damage."
But Apex over Fortnite.
Apex.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I would definitely put Apex over Fortnite. And Overwatch, I did used to play a lot of Overwatch. So I do freaking love the game. When I stopped playing it and I came back to it,
trash.
Trying to guard her now. I go lie, I'm kind of garbage now. Because I forgot.
I'll take you under my wing.
Yeah, so I'm going to have to get some lessons from Silverfang right here. Because he's pretty OP at that shit.
He's about to be in the league, y'all. Watch out for that.
Yeah.
It's going to be league.
So, but yeah, Apex over Fortnite. Overwatch would probably be a tie with Apex for me.
And Overwatch 2 coming out? But,
I'm excited for that. I'm excited for Overwatch 2.
Genji with that hoodie.
Was
he right is now. Clean.
Now, for me,
fuck up train.
Apex and Fortnite. Alright? They're both Battle Royale games, right? Okay. So, Fortnite, they do have more characters in it. Way more characters, way more customization, way more shit. Okay, train. Thomas in the background trying to make a video. A lot of y'all don't know who the hell Thomas is. That's what's.
No, it's they crazy. Watch Chuggington.
Anyways.
I have
So, it's hand to hand.
I give you that. Like,
Fortnite has way more customization, way more shit. The only thing I hate about Fortnite...
Building.
The fucking builders, yep. Man. They just sit there and build.
Yep.
Of course, it's like the abilities in Apex, right? But that building shit begin to annoy
at least
sometimes.
The abilities in Apex have a cooldown.
Again, like I said, they're just ripping off Overwatch on that. But, you know, this is kind of like the one good game EA has ever put out, besides Sims.
Sims is lit.
Yeah.
And you could thank Respawn for that.
EA, get your shit together. Anyways.
Xbox, Microsoft's coming for us.
So, Fortnite, they do have more. They have more of a story. Apex is getting the story in right now. But every season, and they also have the story mode, which I haven't played yet, but I heard it's pretty lit. It's pretty lit, the story mode. And that you can build your own map and all that other shit. They should do that in Apex. That'd be kind of lit. Build your own fucking map. Fight a few of your buddies. Hmm. Apex, one thing I will say. Y'all executions? Whew. Beautiful. Loba, wifey, number two. No, wait.
50.
Nah, Loba probably wifey number five. There's other wifeys. You feel me? But anyways, I'm about to get killed when I get home. But I would say Apex.
My will.
Apex do have more of a weapon variety right now. Fortnite
the
took
characters
a,
have personality too.
They have personality too. The only characters that have personalities
rest
is when they do the new season and they do their little shits, and that's kind of lit. But come on, Fortnite, do some more storytelling, you know? Get people involved. Each character got to have, like, a backstory or something. Y'all make millions. Then y'all already are. And start paying people for the emotes that y'all steal. How about that? But anyways, that's it for that.
Now we're getting...
That's a lot of tea, but that's none of my business, though.
That's a lot of shade going on. That's some pocket shade from that, dude.
Can I just get a ripping chat for Pathfinder? That nigga staying in the lobby for a while. Until,
unless I have to play him for a challenge.
Yeah, exactly. The only time I play Pathfinder is when I have to complete a challenge with them. Because honestly, that grapple.
Sad when Gibraltar is more useful than Pathfinder.
Exactly. What's sad is that Gibraltar is now the fastest healer on the team. Like,
but he's the slowest character.
Like, Lifeline used to be the fastest healer, which was cool. I love that about Lifeline. Now Lifeline's OP as fuck with her fucking drone shield rezzing people. That's freaking awesome. So all you Lifeline mains or wannabe Lifeline mains, go check that out. Like I said, throw Pathfinder away. Or Respawn, go fix that shit. 45 seconds for a fucking grapple.
Another thing about Fortnite, it's not copying Apex. Apex. As soon as Apex came out, they were like, oh, let's add a pinging system. Let's add a respawn beacon. They added a sniper that's Pathfinder's ability.
Which sniper?
It was like Storm Scout Sniper, which would like allow you to see where the next circle will be.
Oh, that shit. Yeah.
But you never know. Fortnite probably had this shit in the works for a minute. I think they're just helping each other out, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I can see that. They're just helping each other out at this point. Because it's like, I think they have like a meeting. They'd be like, all right, so what are you adding? All right, you add that in your game. I'm going to add this in mine. We're going to see how you work out. Me here next week? Okay, cool. Next week. All right, that shit didn't work out. That shit was boo-boo. do not put mechs in your game. That shit was trash. Do not do that.
Even though I like the mechs.
Yeah.
I mean, it makes sense in Titanfall.
Apex. Titanfall. Add options where you can play solos and you can play squads.
Hopefully Respawn sees this.
Make it four people, man.
Squads.
Yeah.
Because y'all already got three. Y'all already got two. I'm doing fine, though. I can't even talk. I'm doing fabulous. Add solos. Because fucking randoms.
Mm-hmm.
And then add four people. And we're good. But those are all the questions, right?
Yep.
I want to
touch on one more thing.
Pause.
No, I'm not. Kind of late. How's the game, man?
Do you have sex on?
All I know is once Hyperscape comes out, I'm going to be taking a break from Apex.
Bro. We gonna stream that.
We gonna try out this Hyperscape shit.
We definitely gonna upload some of that shit.
I'm kind of annoyed that PC players get to play it first, so they become OP as fuck. So that way, when console players get it, they're gonna be complete garbage. But that's no big deal. We'll deal with them in the arena when we see them.
Yeah, when they kill y'all.
One video. All right, we're done here. We go train offline. We're going to go in the hyperbolic time chamber on this bitch. Yeah.
Just rewind. You know what? I'm going back to Apex.
Fuck this. But anyways, thank y'all for participating in our first Q&A. We're going to do more videos of this if y'all like it. Get it past 15 likes. If y'all get it past 15 likes, I'll upload another video this week of another Q&A so y'all can ask three questions.
In the comments below, please.
In the comments below.
We really want to hear from y'all.
15 likes. If we can get a 15 likes, when this shit goes up, 15 likes. I'll do that video right then and there for another Q&A. Now that video probably will drop maybe next week, but yeah. So. So, everybody, stay happy, stay positive, and stay healthy, and I'll see y'all at the top because the bottom's too crowded. Wolf Empire. Signing out. At dinner with Hope, hoping that he passed the baton. He just passed the patron. Ain't yes. Nothing given, dog. It's earned. If you just living, dog, you learn. I let you niggas see the light. I'm like the prison yard. I yearn for that living loss. But mama, I ain't done yet. Sit back and watch your sunrise. Kick back and know your sunset. Forever, I ain't run yet and never will. Nas told me life's a bitch. Pac said, fuck the world, and I ain't come yet.